Schneiderman.
Does whatever a spider can. Look out! Here comes
Schneiderman.
G'day Saints fans, welcome to another edition of Snyderman. Today we have with us, as voted by you, Josh Bruce. Thanks for joining us, mate.
Thanks, Adam. Thanks for having me. Feeling pretty nervous, but excited.
Oh, we'll get straight into it, mate. First question from the fans. This one's from Duncan. He wants to know, is the man bun the secret to your success?
I'm not sure if it has any special powers or anything like that, but just being myself and having my hair how I want it, I guess. So, yeah, I'm not sure.
Okay, good answer. This next one is from Kelza Dab. Has to be St Kilda Football Club has to be about his modelling career, dry as a bone. What is next? Akubra hats?
Don't mind Akubra hats? I don't know, I'm not sure. Got given an invitation to do a little bit for dry as a bone and took it up. As you know, you've done similar things in the past, I think, Adam. So, yeah.
You're pretty proud of your photo shot there?
No, I'm a little bit embarrassed, but it's good quality gear, so get on to it.
No worries, thanks for that question. The next one we got is from Simo Lindell. How are you going to get Rui to get out of the way when he returns?
There won't be any of that. We'll be working together real closely. We always have, and we've got a good relationship. So.
Perfect. And this one's from James Burnett. Sir Bruce, do you think playing in the back line helped you as a forward? And of the forwards you play with, on which one do you learn the most from?
I think, yeah, a little bit. I think definitely at AFL level I've learned a fair bit off opposition defenders, like playing on blokes like Josh Kennedy and Jack Darling, their work rate, and obviously at the Saints, Nick Riewoldt, someone I've learned a lot off. So
beautiful. Now, mate, tell us a little bit how you grew up. Back in the day, you told me a story about an apple core incident. Can you tell us about that, please, with your mum?
As I was younger, obviously around the kitchen table, you get encouraged to eat all your fruit and veggies, and if you don't eat them, you don't get to leave the table or play outside or whatever. So I think it was one afternoon. My parents were big advocates on eating a lot of fruit, so they were making me eat this apple, and I really didn't feel like eating this apple. I wasn't enjoying it at all, so I did the old, go to the bathroom trick, and I'd had taken about two bites out of this massive pink lady apple. And I was like, I'll stuff this, I'm just going to flush it down the toilet and then it'll go away, because I'd done that with vegetables and stuff in the past, you know, when you get stuck at the kitchen table, you get the tissues and you flush it down the toilet. Kids don't do that at home. Anyway, flush this apple down the toilet, and next thing you know, the water starts rising up out of the toilet, and I'm thinking, oh no, block the toilet here. Anyway, I've left it and gone outside, and then the old man's obviously gone in next time we need to go to the toilet and seen it's all blocked up, and he's come out and he's gone, oh, who's bloody blocked this toilet up, you know, what's the go here? And obviously deny, so didn't put my hand up about it, and then, you know, he was trying to get the plunger out and trying to unblock the toilet for a couple of days, and then he's a builder and he got one of his plumber mates in, and they had to take the whole toilet out, and then halfway down the pipe the pink lady had blocked up the major pipe to the toilet. And then, obviously hit us up about who flushed the apple down the toilet, and I had to pull my hand up, and I copped it for sure.
Do you eat apples these days?
Yeah, don't mind them. Certainly don't have a phobia of them, but don't mind them at all.
Now, another story I've got from your brother. Apparently, one day when you're about four or five, you got kicked out of the car and your mum drove off on you, and apparently she came back about 10 minutes later and you're bawling your eyes out. Is this true as well?
Yeah, it was. I think I used to, because mum used to trust us with the child lock or whatever, I used to open the door up while we were driving along and just like be a pest, just in general.
Sounds like you.
And she said, if you do that one more time, I'm going to leave you on the side of the road. Naturally, about 10 seconds later, I did it. And to a word, she left me on the side of the road, and I was so scared, I couldn't believe it. And then she came back and picked me up, and certainly never did that again. Learned my lesson.
Oh, that's good. The next one is, you got any pets at home?
I do. I have a young puppy called Django.
Django? What kind of puppy is he?
He's a Groodle, Golden Retriever, Poodle.
So he's pretty hairy. He's got a lot of hair.
He does have a lot of hair, yeah.
Is it a true. You also, when you have your little top knot bun in your hair, you like to do the same to him so he looks like you? Confirm or deny, please.
I can deny that. It was actually, once again, my girlfriend. I was actually away on a footy trip a couple of weeks ago, and I think she got a bit bored at home and tied Django up into a little top knot and sent it out on Snapchat. So,
fair enough.
This would be interesting, though.
Well, now we've got a couple of photos of your lovely hairs. You've had a few over the years, a few shockers, I might add. But here's the first one. Can you explain this? Who wears it better?
Definitely the person on the left. I don't know what I was thinking last year, Snods, but I've sacked my hairdresser, so.
And the next one is another haircut this year, I think this one is. It is the last one after kick six at the Gold Coast. Are you pretty happy with this one, just like the dog is?
Yeah, he's got the ears pinned back as well, doesn't he? It's good.
Oh, mate, you're known around the club for your hair anyway. You've got a different one every year. So I've traced down a few photos of you when you were younger. Here's some more. I don't know how to describe this one, but can you describe what you were thinking here or what you were going for?
Not sure. I was growing it long, but it was just awful. Just a bit of a... 70s kind of throwback. It was awful, yeah.
Questionable.
And this photo I'm just not sure about, but can you explain this one too?
I was actually on a bus trip, on a rowing trip when I was about 15, so yeah, just being an idiot, you know, as you are, mate.
Yep. And this one here is just another one of your classics, mate.
You cut the fake Ray-Bans from Thailand there, mate. one of the old times.
Well, since we've been talking about hair, we're going to bring on to the next one. Now, you obviously, if anyone gets a haircut at the footy club, you're right on to them. You really, you give them what you think, you know, score out of 10, tell them if it's shocking or not. So we're going to ask you to give us a few here. The first one here, how do you reckon he takes this one?
Is that JT?
Yep.
Nah, putrid. Putrid cornrows, no good, especially on a white man.
Not happy with that one, that's fair enough. The next one we got.
Brittany, not bad. She went through a tough time, I think. Bit stressed out.
I don't know who this is, but you might.
What?
Rating out of 10?
Look, that's a one. What's he done there? Half shaved, half not. That's awful.
Okay, that brings me to the next one, the old half shave, half not. My favourite, what is this, Juicy? This is your first game for the footy club, a new club. What were you thinking at this time?
I'm not sure. Not sure. I was going for the bun, but it didn't go in, wasn't long enough. And the beard's just awful. So, look, I'll put my hand up and say I've made some errors with my hair over the years. But, don't know what I can say.
What do you reckon the Hulk Hogan would have said about that one if he saw you down at the footy club the other day?
Probably would have decked me, I reckon.
Very good. All right, mate, brings me on to my next part, the favourite part of the Snyder Man, the singing. Now, you've prepared a song for us, mate. What song have you got for us you're going to sing?
Just going to sing a little number from Happy Gilmore. From Adam Sandler.
Well, here's the mic, mate. Take it away.
I want to kiss you all over and over and again. Wanna kiss you all over, dun dun dun, till the night closes in, till the night closes in.
Well, there you have it, guys. Josh Bruce, hope you enjoyed that. I certainly enjoyed the singing bit. So, mate, as we do every week, we give it up to you to choose who we can put up for vote for next week. So, who do you reckon?
I'd say three Jacks: Jack Loney, Jeff Sinclair, and Jill Nunes.
Beautiful. There you have it, guys. Until then, go Saints.
Schneiderman.
Does whatever a spider can. Look out. Here comes
Schneiderman.